Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another installment of Let's Play Until Dawn Live. Oh boy, what a week. I've actually been kind of waiting to do this, stream again, just because I'm going to be honest with you guys, the writing in this game is hideously bad, and I'm kind of waiting for people to, I'm waiting for the game to be over, just because, oh my god, just... There's so many problems. Don't mind me, guys. I'm actually just doing the usual pre-show setup and still have to get the watch page up because I don't trust the chat with this game because it fucked up the last time. I just noticed we have 6 viewers in. Welcome. Okay, let me just mute the stream because I don't need to hear that coming out of my other headset. Still have to put on the thumbnail and then we can begin this shit. Woo! So... to recap what has happened in the previous installments of this, so there were these sisters, and they died. Their brother's a heartless dick who, 1 year later decides to celebrate their death by bringing everybody who helped facilitate the death, go all back to the same lodge and party like porn stars. That was his exact quote. and we may have one death so far. Not totally sure. That one ended kind of suddenly. That one segment in the last episode just sort of ended, like, out of fucking nowhere. So, are we ready for this? Dear God, I hope so. Let's fucking do this. Woo! Oh yeah, I forgot they do the previously ons. So...
hold on!
There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. Apparently, he had warned them against pursuing their construction project in Blackwood Pines.
Where the fuck's all this audio coming from? I don't remember ever hearing anything from a sheriff.
I-S-T. Sister?
And here's them playing with the spirit board.
What sister is it then?
Run! Oh my god.
Ash!
Oh, yeah, and then these two get drug off to a rape fucking dungeon somewhere. Right here's the bit I was talking about, where the chick with the killer arm gets, Yeah, she actually was the one who murdered the bird with a fucking snowball. She looks to be gone. Hopefully she is dead. Chapter 4. Loyalty.
Oh, fuck, what the fuck? Jessica! Oh my god!
There's no way that fucking gun is loaded.
Jess! Jess!
I am not about to believe that somebody would actually leave a rifle in an old cabin with ammo still in it. How long has it been since anybody was, fuck it, let's just follow the path. Don't care. How long has it been since somebody was actually in that fucking cabin? Whoop, oh, I almost missed that. So, how long has it been since someone was last in that cabin? Do we even know if that ammo is still any good? Provided that the moron who left the gun there was stupid enough to leave bullets in it? I'm just curious, guys! Open fire! Come on, let me shoot!
Jess!
Damn.
No!
Well, Jess is still alive. Fancy that. Fine, jump down. Jump!
Fuck.
Well, there goes my... wow, there goes my everything. There goes the gun. Never mind. Oh, and the lantern is still working too. Good. Oh my god, I can actually play! Well, QuickTime events aren't really playing, but still, I'm going to count it. This is like the most, interaction I've had all fucking game. Alright, come on, dude, shimmy. Remember? You told her to shimmy. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. Okay. There we go. Oh I actually, guys, was kind of thrown off by the fact that I actually had to do shit there. Ooh, slide.
Oh, no, damn it!
I'm actually kind of wondering what would have happened if I would have missed that. Would I have just kept on sliding and just slammed into the floor? Yeah, and we're back to the push fucking extra buttons to pick up to pick up shit. That's just... Okay, we will take the elevator, I guess. You know, Mike, you could go a little faster. Like, the game doesn't even give, like, a sprint function. I really, really love this, how Jessica's in mortal fucking danger. Oh, but we are just gonna just traipse through here. No fucking biggie.
Jessica!
I don't even know if I'm going the right fucking way. Let's see. Yeah, you know, there's like no big rush, Mike. You just take your time. Just a walk in the park, nothing big, yeah.
No! Oh, God!
And nothing
Jessica!
Of value was lost.
No, Jessica. No, Jessica!
It just gets better! Oh, yes. Holy fuck, there actually was ammo in that. Who the fuck leaves a gun fully loaded like that? Mind you guys, at no point did Mike ever have to find fucking bullets for it. Like, the gun was loaded. Jesus, do the people who made this game know anything about, like, firearm safety? Fuck it, I'm just going to go quick. Why? Because screw this. Come on there, muscles. You can fucking power up there. Yeah, shimmy. We get to shimmy.
Come on.
I am going to continue to shimmy. All thanks to what he told her to fucking shimmy.
Okay.
Shimmy, shimmy.
Okay.
Oh, wait. I'm just shimmying, like, right back to the same spot, aren't I? Okay, that's fine. Fuck it. Jump. My God. I'm so happy I actually get to, like, interact with this interactive game. Okay, so... shimmying back was probably a bad idea. You got this, bud.
Shit. There he is. How do you know that's him, Mike? It might be another weirdo just randomly in here.
So, it had one bullet in it. Good.
Ice gotta make it.
Come on, slide underneath there, Indy. Wait, how the fuck? Wait. Motherfucker, you were looking for matches in the previous chapter. Where the fuck did that Zippo come from? No, seriously, where the hell did the lighter come from? He needed fucking matches in the light. Oh my God. Fuck this game. So how was my day? The chat's asking how my day was. My day was pretty good. It was a pretty quiet day. I really didn't do much. It was a day off from work, so I'm always happy about that.
Jesus. What the fuck is that place?
And now I'm here playing this and questioning a whole lot of the inconsistencies, logic holes, and other such goofy, stupid bullshit that comes with this game. So good news is we've got one dead person. It's incredibly loud down fucking stairs. That's starting to just annoy me. I really hope you guys can't hear that.
Ashley?
Oh. Okay, so which one's Chris again? Oh, yeah, Chris is the, like, pussy.
Ash.
Okay. So, let's see. Someone in the chat is asking if I like root beer.
Not good.
Kinda.
Not good at all.
I mean, it's not exactly like a... It really isn't exactly like a high fucking, like, priority drink for me, but I'll totally drink it if I have no other options. So, let's see. I was stuck on something there. Open up.
What the fuck?
Well, that is new.
Oh, shit. No.
Alright, we can back away. Unless, am I able to, like, run a fucking finger across it or something? Oh, no, but I am able to track the light over it. That's a very odd splatter. That's very unique. Who's dead? Jess. She, oh god, that
Ash.
Death was fucking glorious. Chris, shut up.
Ash?
Shut up. So, let's see what's down here, huh? I really love how there is, like, imminent horrible danger, like, everywhere, but everybody just sort of waltzes around
Ashley!
Like it's fucking nothing.
Ashley?
I don't even know if I'm going in the right fucking direction. The game's kind of, actually...
Anyone out there? Ashley?
Yeah, I look to be following, like, drag marks. I just saw the drag marks on the ground, so... Call it a hunch, I have a feeling she's out here someplace. Yeah, we got some birds. This game still isn't, like, ultimately, like, terrifying or frightening or anything. Well, hello, what have we got here? Hang on a sec, guys. Well, that was different. Alright, why don't we inspect
this?
Hmm. Trying to figure out if that's supposed to be like a real head or like a rubber head. And considering all the pranks and shit which these idiots do, it wouldn't shock me if it was a rubber head. Looks sort of cool though. All right, we'll move past the scarecrow thingamajig. What hell? Found another totem. Well, that's loading. Actually, I might as well see this. So it's another death, you know, totem. Hell, it's... I think that's, what, my second death totem? Yes, it is. So I'm going to take a look at the chat here for just a sec. So am I excited for Kong Skull Island? Hell no. Because it's fucking Kong. I have no reason to be excited for a King Kong movie.
Aw, shit.
Wait, how the hell is a pig's head a clue, game? Okay, so it ties into the Mystery Man line of clues. Which also included, of course, this joyous little fucking drawing from a while back. Oh god, and then there's the fucking note. Yes, the note. I will make them bleed. Or I will take them and bleed them like pigs and rip their soft white skin off. God damn, that is so shit. Okay. So, anyway, moving swiftly onwards. We actually should name this guy, even though he's not going to show up at any other point in the game. I think I'm just going to call you Mitch, just because I feel like it. So have fun there, Mitch. You keep guarding the pig head. Still not sure where I'm fucking going, in all seriousness. Alright, let's just continue down the normal path.
Ash!
You know, Chris, if you're gonna call out for Ashley, it might help if you were, you know, like, louder about it. Because I don't think walking around the woods, Ash, is gonna do any good. Unless she's like 6 inches away from you, she's not gonna be able to fucking hear you. Alright, hold on, I just saw something else in the chat. See. Guess who has a rematch that even. I'm just gonna skip that. It actually kinda sort of. It actually kinda looked like a bigger thing in the chat. I thought it'd be something of interest. So.
Ashley?
Chris, I swear to God, shut up. You know, it's actually kind of weird. Like, there's, like, all this kind of shit, like, around here. You'd think there'd be some way of, like, interacting with some of it. But oh well. Yeah, and apparently, John has picked up on the, thing that him walking around, Ashley, is reminding people of Heavy Rain. And I only know Ashley. About that. I still have never played Heavy fucking Rain. I just know the whole press X to fucking, like, press. I just know of the press X to Jason meme. Jason! God, I actually should play that at some
Ash,
point.
Ash, I'm here. Where are you?
I don't know.
Are you
well,
okay?
That's real helpful,
what
Ashley.
Please, help me.
Well, I can't help you if I don't know where you are, you silly
what
bitch.
Happened?
Hello. Oh,
Chris,
dude.
Are you there?
Hello. And thank you all for joining me.
I want to play a game.
We're going to conduct a little experiment, sort of test. Now, for this experiment, we'll need the cooperation of our two test subjects, Joshua and Ashley.
What?
Oh my God.
But we're going to need one more brave participant to help decide which subject will live. And which will die?
No.
Oh, this is too easy.
Please, everyone calm down. It's all very simple. Christopher, you will find a lever placed directly in front of you. All you have to do is choose who you will save.
Hello, Chris. I want to play a game.
Give me
Okay, this is gonna be okay.
Decisions,
oh, dude,
decisions,
buddy,
decisions.
Just think about this for a minute.
Do I take? Do I save the one who's got no personality to speak of? Or do I kill? Or do I save the one who's irritating and ugly as shit and is the reason why we're all fucking here? Nope, I'm gonna save Ashley because fuck you, bitch.
I won't let you die.
Thank
Please,
you.
No.
Oh, Josh. You are so done.
This is insane. This is not just an habit. Chris, please tell me this.
I see. You've chosen to save Ashley.
No, Chris. No. No.
God, let's see this.
Why would you do this?
Well, Josh, you know, I could just say that it was all just a fucking prank, but no, I want to see this. Oh, that was so satisfying.
I'm coming, Ash. I'm gonna get you.
That was so good.
Stop, please. Come on, let's get you down. Come on, we're gonna get you out of here.
Oh, that was so good.
We gotta go, okay?
No. So, that's two down. Oh, dude. Yes.
Chris. Ashley.
What? Whose butt is that, Ash?
Are you okay?
Chris, what happened?
Josh.
Josh, what, dude?
He's dead.
Wait,
not
what?
Right in front of us, man.
What are you talking about?
There's a maniac.
Maniac.
Oh my god, we gotta get out of here.
I don't understand.
A maniac who's seen a few too many Saw films. Let's just put it that way and let's go back to the lodge. And hopefully then if dipshit is out of the bathtub, then she can wash Josh's blood off of her. So
I killed him.
No, Chris.
I killed him. It was my fault, man.
Oh, so Patrick just showed up. Yeah, we lost two, you know, characters.
We need to go get help now.
Both of them were incredibly irritating, so I really you can just tell I am so torn up by them. I am so torn up by the loss of some dude who apparently was on some stupid show I've never heard of. And the chick who can kill a bird with a snowball. Both of them are gone. Right now, the only other one I want to see die is that stupid girl. I'm not no her. I want that bitch dead like yesterday. Dr. Hill! Dude, what's up? I actually kind of like your decoration there, man. The saw blade in Mitch's head looks awesome. That really was Mitch's head, too. That right there is like the awesome part.
Hello again. Things are getting pretty tense up there, aren't they? Is the night going the way you hoped it would?
God damn it all, it's just getting louder down there. I really hope that you guys can't, you know, hear that.
And you think that these poor people are getting what they deserve?
Wait, turn this up a bit. Yeah, who the fuck are you, Dr. Hill?
I'm trying to help you.
Oh, are you now?
Game you're playing. You understand that it's not good for you. It's not good for anyone. And I can't say that you're being particularly honest in the way you're playing.
You know, I would really like a whole game focused around Dr. Hill. I actually do find him to be very fascinating.
Do you intend to continue this elaborate self-indulgence?
Yeah, I do. You got a problem with that bitch?
Do you even believe that I am real?
No, because you're a character in a video game.
The heart of the problem, it all comes down to this. Can you really tell the difference anymore?
Yeah, I can tell the difference. I have a feeling that my choices are triggering Dr. Hill, which I find kind of funny. Oh god, that is just too fucking good.
That could be a lot of things. None of them nice.
Quit it.
Here's our one-way ticket to the spirit realm.
I've just been through enough spooking for one night, okay? I see a hot bath in my crystal ball. So have fun.
Why would you do this? Magic! Oh, God! Ah! Ah! Jessica! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
Shit. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently
Seriously,
unknown.
At what you know, point did the sheriff's audio ever come into play except for these, like, previously on things? It's, starting to just bother me. Chapter 5. Dread. 6 hours until...
That's not good. That's really not good.
You know, Mike, perhaps maybe instead of wandering around, you could try to find your friends, or what's left of them. I can tell you right now, if you have to go into his shed, you could totally find what's left of Josh just sort of hanging around. Oh, God. Oh, shit.
Damn it.
See, and I really don't remember hearing the sheriff audio when she was on the bus. It might have been. I'm probably going to have to go back and watch the previous stream, but, yeah, I don't really remember that. Seriously, Mike, why the fuck are you diving into this shit solo? You know you've got friends all, like, in a lodge. But no, you're just gonna try to fucking, like, Rambo this as casually as possible. It's like, yep, da-da-da-da, waltzing into a death trap, da-da-da-da-dee, fucking moron. Try to find matches one chapter, have a fucking Zippo in next. I'm sorry, guys, if that seems really petty, but it kind of bothers me a bit. It's a fucking plot hole, and it's a real noticeable one. Well, I do kind of like the sound of wolves. Hello, what have we here?
Awesome.
Condemned.
Why wouldn't I end up in the creepiest place on planet Earth?
It is deemed unlawful for any person to use or occupy this structure forthwith. June 12th, 1954. Jesus Christ, a condemned building from 1954 still up? Damn. And for a fucking condemned building, man, this sucker's in beautiful shape. I mean, you know, like paint, some new windows. This thing honestly would be, like, probably almost kind of sort of livable. Shit. Alright, bud, storm in. It's time to fucking do this. Seriously, dude? You see a fucking room with what look to be angry guard fucking dogs there, and your first instinct is to go for the door. You are a dumb motherfucker, Mike. Oh, shit. Okay. So. There's gotta be like a... Wow, that turning was kind of messed up. There's gotta be like a security pass. I also found it funny that he went for the doorknob, even though it clearly stated right on the door you need a security key to get in.
Look at that.
The Blackwood Pines Sanatorium, opened 1922. Mensana in corpore sano. Nice. Wait, so the building was only active for 30 years before it was condemned. Still trying to figure out why it was condemned. I'm just looking at the architecture, man. This is a nice looking place. I mean, yeah, sure, it's kind of sort of gone to pot a little, but still, you know, a lick of paint, some new lights, some new windows. Maybe put like a big screen way in the back here. This place honestly would be almost like livable. Aha. Okay. How the fuck is a broken camera a clue, game? Oh, for 1952, right along with the old mask and the mine danger map. All right. Let's see. Anything else around here outside of the broken camera? Da, 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 da. Not seeing much else, so turn right around and we head this way. Oh yes, please, game, let me fucking go down to the morgue. I will in just a moment. I kind of want to check out the rest of this floor, because I'm going to assume that the morgue is, like, downstairs. Ah, what ho? There's something here. So this is from 1952. Reporter assaulted on Blackwood Mountain. See, a reporter from the Alberta Bugle was assaulted and hospitalized yesterday by security personnel at the Blackwood Sanatorium. Chuck Bernstein, a senior news reporter, was seeking an interview and blah, 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 da, 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 Jeffrey Berg, sole proprietor of the, da, 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 blah, 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 bullshit, who gives a shit? Okay, moving onward. Plus, I believe that is listed now as a, like, clue, isn't it? Oh, look at that, my honesty went down. My relationship status is all going up. That's always good. Yeah, what about the butterfly effect? Okay. Alright, yeah, so it actually shows, like, which choice you make. Okay, and then you can actually, like, flip through. Alright, never mind. Let's just move right along. Actually, no, I came in here specifically to look at the clues. So that'd be underneath 1952. Yep, right there. The old newspaper. Okay. Let's see. Don't mind me, I was just looking at the chat. Alright, onward to the morgue. Or first. Did I just see a rat up in the beams? Cool. Okay, this is a minor medical report attending, and the attending physician was Dr. NHF Bowen. Report follows reason the initial state of the 12 miners after the collapse of the mine and the subsequent rescue at Blackwood Pines. The receipt of 12 patients in the sanatorium's medical facility, we had expected to find emaciated shells of men starved and confused. Thankfully, the miners appear cogent, relatively healthy, attributed to their apparent discovery of emergency food supplies in the mine, which I'm going to assume would translate to there actually were 13 and they decided to just feast on one. At least that would be my guess. That's probably me trying to get a little bit dark in a game that really is trying desperately to be all dark and shit, really isn't doing it. Again, I do have to applaud how casually he's just walking through this place, knowing full well the dangers that are lurking within. So. Well, what have we got here? Okay, yeah.
So you go. Shit.
Come on, dude, grab that. No, it's not fucking gross. It's a fucking weapon, dumbass. Take it. Yes. Okay, how the fuck do you have that thing holstered? Oh, okay. You just happen to have a loop on the side of your pants built specifically for that. That's... No, no, no. I am not gonna let that swing. At what point did jeans come with a fucking holster for, of all things, a motherfucking machete? And if you guys look, the loop is only wide enough for the narrow end there. How the fuck did he... Never mind. I'm not gonna ask how the fuck he fit that thing in there, because it's just... God damn you, game. You're supposed to do a better fucking job at this sort of shit. Again, you know, place probably wouldn't be too bad under optimum circumstances. It really is a nice-looking place. Oh boy. I just saw the shadow of a fucking dog. That's probably gonna come back to haunt me soon. Reply immediately. Reporters and other snoopers to be kept away at all costs. Western Province Telecommunications Company Telegram. There's an update. 12 survivors received at the sanatorium showing signs of mental trauma. May need to... Mental trauma. Again, I'm going to assume that they probably feasted on one of their own. Local press now have the scent of blood becoming a problem. Please advise further. Yeah, so... they are having a problem with snooping fucking reporters. Well, gee. I wouldn't call them snooping. I mean, it's like... you took in 12 fucking miners who, were caught in, like, a fucking, like, collapse. You obviously should have been expecting something. Oh, well, look at this. Well, look at this jaunty little fucking customer here. Look at him. He's just all smiling and happy. Sup, buddy? Okay, moving onward. Let's take a look at this. I was just looking at the chat, guys. I'm sorry. How high were the writers of this, you know, game? I really don't think that they were high. I just think they were fucking stupid. There's a big, big difference. Being high might actually have led to something, like, creative. Another rat. Very cute. Wait a minute. Am I seeing that right? Yeah, and I can't even get to it from here. That looks like a fucking why would there be an electric chair? And I do not want to hear for the sake of shock therapy, because... huh. That's cute. Anyway, what I was going to say was, I don't want to hear it's for the sake of shock therapy, because that's not how shock therapy's done. Well, that there was my fault. Try prying the bear trap open, you stupid gimp. You've got a fucking machete. Pry the bear trap open. Really, Gabe? No. I'm not gonna amputate my fucking fingers, you stupid. Okay, never mind. Maybe I should have amputated my fucking fingers. Fine. Choppy choppy.
Oh shit.
You got
this,
bud.
Oh shit.
You got this. Come on.
Oh shit.
Come on, dude.
Oh shit.
Come on, man.
Oh shit.
Eye of the tiger. You can do this. Come on, man. You have to fucking chop harder, man. You have to hack the fucking bone. There you go. Atta boy. Well, look, he's still fucking smiling. Isn't that ever cute? Oh, goddamn. Yeah. Yeah, you have to wipe your own blood off of the blade, but you didn't bother to wipe off the blood that was on it when you first grabbed it, you sped.
Let him go, I don't know what the fuck to go. Okay.
Really? That one there was totally my fault. I'd probably still have a couple extra fingers and a full blade if I didn't do that. Anyway, I am not about to feel guilty about that. Let's, what have we got here?
This place just gets better and better.
What the fuck? Strange skull. Huh. A disfigured human head suspended in formaldehyde. Cute. That really is a cool looking skull. I actually wouldn't mind owning something like that. Probably a plastic one, like, in some kind of gel, because formaldehyde stinks, so. Alright, what do we got here? Come on, pull it out already. Emergency medical tag for a Nicholas Bowen, tagged February 24th, 1952. Description, attack by inmate, fatal lacerations to the throat. Well, shit. Isn't that ever cute? I guess I should have figured, considering the head on the toe tag was circled. Alright, what about this one? Open up. There. Well, what have we got here? It's... Name of the deceased is Sarah Smith. Date of death, February 24th, 1952. I hereby certify that I attended the deceased from March 8th to February 24th. And last we saw alive, February 24th, 1952. Cause of death, severe lacerations to the abdomen and intra-abdominal injuries, subsequent blood loss. If death was due to external causes, violence, fill in also following accident, suicide, or homicide, homicide, manner of injury, possibly fingernails. Somebody gutted her with fingernails. Okay, that's a whole pay dirt. We finally have a body. We're gonna get a jump scare from this, aren't we? That was awesome. Well, now we've got a security card. Good.
Okay, ooh. Let's check this out.
So, good news, we finally have a card to get through that door. Bad news, it cost us a couple of fingers, so... Might want to take the pass card, pal. There we go. All right. So, let's see. Da-da-dum-da-da-da. Just casually wandering through. You would almost think that, you know, considering the, like, the lost fingers, the... loss of fucking blood, the fact that he didn't have any time to, like, sterilize it, you would think he'd be in kind of a rush to get out of here, but no. What's up, Poach? I think I can turn the TV down, but this is not really a cutscene. I'm actually kind of surprised we didn't have any, like, QTEs for that, because you think, you know, running from a dog and all that, that might, you know, lead to something, but nope. All right. What the hell? Let's take a look out here.
It's a quaint little psycho crib.
Place actually looks... Okay. I think I may have figured out why the place was fucking condemned, guys. Might be the giant hole in the ceiling. Call it a hunch. It's normally not healthy for snow to come pouring in like that. So, onward to the chapel. Going to the chapel and we're... Oh, boy. Come on, Mike. Man up and jump. Or, you know, just go... Or, you know, just sit down and slide off. Either way works.
Back in here.
So why is Mike in the loony bin? John's asking. Well, you see, Mike is in the loony bin because after watching Jess die, he just decided to wander around like a fucking dunce and kind of found his way here. Instead of actually going to try to find the rest of his friends and, you know, let them know what happened. No, he's just gonna wander. So, knowing that this is like a psychotic's den... Alright. Oh, shit. Okay. Stay put, bud. Sorry, Pooch. Yeah, you go have a seat.
Easy.
I'm fine.
Easy. That's a good boy.
Sit, boy. Or lie down. Either way works. That really is a beautiful dog, too. I just should mention. Hey, bud. It's all right. Go ahead. Approach him. He seems...
That's a good boy. That's
right. Seems friendly enough. No, no. It's okay, pal. Easy. No. Dumbass. Back of your hand.
Good boy. Yeah.
Show the dog the back of your hand.
Guy? You like that?
Yeah, look at you, pal.
Everyone likes a little love.
Yeah,
right?
Look at you, little sweetie. Look at that. So, what else we got around here? All the noise downstairs continues to get louder and louder, and it slowly drives me fucking nuts. Anyway,
so,
what have we got here?
What have we here?
Well, good news, Mike. You finally have a fucking coat. Use the force, Mike.
Nice.
Don't tell me. Fucking thing's loaded, isn't it? I'm actually trying to see if I can see if there's any bullets inside there. Actually, I believe that there are. All right. Yes, there's no other way to get in there. Yay. Alright. Hello?
Fucking freak.
Clippings wall. This is still part of the fifth... No, no, this here is part of the Mystery Man quest line. Alright. Bigfoot sighted. Local man found dead. 14 missing in the mountains. 14. So they ate two of them before... So the miners ate two before they went to the hospital. I'm just going to take a guess on that. I don't know. That's... Would not shock me in the slightest if that actually wound up being what happened. Alright, let's continue on. Yeah, that door is not going to let me through. So right there is the exit. I don't really want to leave yet. I mean, yeah, sure, it's awesome that I got a coat and a gun and I'm down two fingers and I got a new dog. I have a new dog friend, but, you know.
Maybe this will keep the wolves fat and happy.
You're not even going to question where those bones are coming from, buddy. Well, it's good to see that his... Well, it's good to see that, his grip hasn't gotten bad after, the shock of chopping off two fucking fingers. Look at how perfectly he carries that fucking lantern. The lantern he lit with a fucking Zippo. That he didn't have the chapter previously. Alright, so let's see what we got here. Continuing on. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else back here. I think I am supposed to head right for the exit. So, actually, let me see if I can interact with... Yep, I thought so. Well, what do you know? Still unfucking smoked. Nice. So that one was part of the Mystery Man clues. Alright. Don't mind me, guys. I am always just sort of curious about where all these clues are leading. Okay, so now let's move onwards. Really, dude? You know, Last time that you just randomly fired at something, dumbass, you didn't bother to check how many fucking rounds you had. And now you just did it again. I can almost guarantee you now, the next time that I have to shoot something, I'm not gonna have a fucking bullet. Because Mike is about as dumb as they come. Who the fuck randomly just grabs a fucking gun anyway? Doesn't bother to check if the safety's on. Doesn't bother to see if there's any, like, rounds in it. I am not even a gun person, and I know that these are basic things you fucking do. And we found another fucking totem, guys. This one's got antlers. Fascinating. Wait, so the magical fucking mystery, you know, lighter is gonna play a role later. Cute. So it goes from plot hole to plot point, just like that. Alright, what do we got here? It's the Miracle Men. These, oh fuck. Alright, I actually kind of wanted to read that, and I forgot I have to actually hold everything down in order to actually do that. The Miracle Men, the successful rescue of all 12 miners trapped in the disaster of 5th of January, 1952. Interesting. Alright, let's see. I really wish that there was, like, I did not want to hit that. Oh! Why the fuck does my honesty keep fucking dropping? I haven't done anything, like, dishonest yet. Okay, so I'm trying to find a way back around here so I can go down the stairs. It is really sad that there is no, like, sprint function in this fucking game. Like, there is no, you know, speed it up some. No, no, just casually fucking saunter through everything. It's actually kind of irritating. Not nearly as irritating as all the noise going on down. I swear to God, guys, I really hope that you guys aren't hearing that, because I'm not totally sure how sensitive the mic is on this thing. I don't know how sensitive my PS4, like, headset is. Okay, so moving swiftly onwards.
Of course, locked.
You're gonna have me shoot this one too, aren't you? No, just throw that. What was the point to that, Mike? See? Dipshit. If you hadn't tipped that, probably wouldn't have such... Oh, you dumb son of a bitch. Well, here we go. We get to follow the psycho again, or not? Oh shit!
I can't believe Josh is dead.
I can't believe how.
Emily, shut up.
No,
I'm saying that. No. Shut your mouth. I'm saying that right now.
You should have checked the shed to see if it was really true.
Oh god. I get to put up with her now. Son of a bitch.
Some things you have to
what the hell? Okay, I was like walking forward and the game just said, nope, and then turned my ass around. That was weird as shit. Wait a minute, are we back over by the ski? Yeah, we are back over by the fucking lift.
I feel better with an axe.
Yeah, I'm going to grab the axe in a sec. I want to see if there's... Okay, just, come on, gimme. There we go. Oh. Okay, so that's a clue? I guess it is. But it's a fucking, like, rather clean axe.
Oh, what now? This is locked, Matt. Well, break the door down, will ya?
Whoa, wait a second. We start smashing shit down, he's gonna hear us.
Well, you got any better suggestions?
I don't know.
Yeah, how about you go take a flying fucking leap, bitch?
What?
Window.
I'm sorry, guys. I really, I genuinely do not like Emily, and I just, Yeah, I'm gonna help squeeze your little fat ass right through that fucking window.
Are you nuts? You're gonna shove my ass through that little hole?
Yes, I am.
I see you slip into some pretty tight jeans, Em.
Excuse me?
It's a talent.
Fine, let's do it.
Get in there, bitch. You're gonna make yourself useful. Okay. Come on. Suck it in.
Oh my god. It's pitch black. I do not like this.
I'm right here, Em.
I can't see anything. There's so much crap in here I keep bumping into.
It's okay. Can you find the latch? Anything.
God damn it, Emily, shut up and open the fucking door.
Black, you dip.
Hey, I'm just trying to be helpful.
Almost, I think. Almost. Ugh.
Did you hear that shit, guys? Oh, there's spiders in here. Shut up.
Please.
You big thundering cunt.
What the hell
Jesus.
Was that?
What?
I'm in the pitch black with spider webs and dust and you just go wandering off?
Em, I just...
Don't Em me. This is a complete and total breakdown of even the slightest glimmer of trust I might have had that you can protect me from the bad things that are out here. And I am just majorly bumming out.
Em, just stop. I'm really sorry. I don't know what I was thinking.
Well, see, you weren't thinking, for one thing.
Oh. Damn.
We were here just a few hours ago. This must have just happened.
What the fuck is going on?
It's gotta be the guy, the one who got to Chris and Ash and John.
What is with the mic pops? I keep having to mute because people downstairs don't know how to shut the fuck up. That's
look,
the problem.
The cable car's all the way out there.
Well, that's not far, right?
So, unfortunately, I have to mute the mic, and that has a rather loud pop on it, unfortunately.
Not that good. Flattered, though.
Well, Matt, if you can't jump that, what are we gonna do?
I don't know.
Well, Matt, I do have one idea of something that you could do. And it involves taking your axe and plunging it deep inside of Emily's skull. And then probably throwing her off of this fucking railing and then watching her body bounce all the way down. Alright, let's go take a look at what was all scrawled back here.
Did a number on this joint.
Such a mess. This place was barely in working condition before, and now...
Hello, what have we got here? Let's see, so we have the sanatorium, ranger path, cable car. That's all it's gonna let me look at.
Something we can do.
I'm all ears.
Look at all this crap. There's gotta be something useful in here, right? Hey, Magellan, maybe we should get the cable car working and take the show on the road, huh?
God, I hate her so fucking much. Alright, what do we got here? Alright, well, there's something glinting there. I'll get to that in a sec.
Very friendly.
Unfollow.
I hate you, Emily. Every time that you open your mouth, I just want you to die in, like, the most violent ways imaginable. So, for some reason, it keeps... Oh, wait, no, let me guess. The glint is... Yeah, the glint is up here, even though it looked like it was in the middle of the fucking floor. Alright, let's turn this shit back on. Or, you know, not.
Great. No keys, no cable car. So, back to square one.
What about the fire tower on the map you found?
Look, I guess it's an option.
Oh my god, you were actually listening?
Or something. I mean, it would, wouldn't it?
Probably, yeah.
Matt, we gotta get to that radio!
No, we need to head back and find everybody else.
That could work, but I kind of think that maybe we should get back to the lodge for now. I mean, everyone's been split up for so long.
Wait, so first you want to leave the lodge, now you want to go back? You don't know what the right thing to do is any more than I do, Matt. And I say that we should go to the fire tower and get on the radio and call for more help. And that's that.
Then why don't you go and find the fucking radio? I'm going to go back to the lodge.
I'm surprised that you don't too.
I do.
Oh, God.
Really?
Oh, hold up.
What's cooking? Good looking?
Getting us out of here, Mr. Meat for Brains.
Mr. Meat for Brains. Emily, you do understand that the brain is technically meat, right? Like, no matter how you want to pretend, I totally understand that you don't know how to use yours. But see, brains,
look at this,
they're made
boy.
Of meat.
You're coming with me, buddy.
God,
just like
I
magic.
Hate
come on down.
So
you can totally get out here this way.
Much. Yeah, come on, dude, shimmy. You gotta shimmy, shimmy. Fuck, I shouldn't.
You're
I
right.
shouldn't have hit that.
Yeah,
shouldn't
thanks,
have hit
maybe,
that. Should have just let the bitch
you
fall.
Go first to protect me.
Swear to God, I just wanted to put an axe right between your eyes.
Okay, easy now.
I have never disliked a video game character this much, guys. It's actually kind of odd.
Whoa.
Okay.
Holy cannoli, thank God that's over.
Yeah, for real.
Holy cannoli. Please, game, let me just put that axe right between her shoulder blades. It's like right here. Nice perfect swing. I'm going barrier in a shallow fucking grave out here. Nobody's going to care.
What if it doesn't work?
What?
The radio.
It'll work.
But
wait.
If it doesn't, we need a plan.
You're just thinking about this now.
We can just climb down.
Climb down what?
You're just thinking.
The mountain.
You were the one who was all gung-ho about doing the fucking radio, Emily, and now. And now here we are. We are on this merry little journey to it, and you're wondering, oh, well. But what if it doesn't work? Fuck you.
The psychopath is just gonna give up and run away.
Fuck you right in the goddamn ear, slut. Oh, fucking hell. Sorry about that, guys. I didn't mean to nudge the mic there.
As long as we don't hide in the lodge, that's where he expects us to go.
How the fuck do you know he wants us all to go to the fucking lodge? What about the buzzsaw trap with Josh? That wasn't in the lodge. See, it seems almost expected he wants us to do everything but go to the fucking lodge. Alright. By the way, I'm kind of proud that I'm slowly beginning to remember the names of all these fucking characters, because all of them are so vapid, shallow, and stupid, I really didn't know I was going to remember any of them. But hell, it's another fucking totem. Which one are you? It's a fortune totem, alright. I think that's only what? Oh, that's only my first. Shit. Yeah, so there's the fortune totem. Found on the mountain by Matt. All right. So, let's do this. Do you even know where the fuck you're going, Emily? I mean, because you weren't the one who picked up the map. You weren't the one who looked at the map.
Watch where you step around.
Yes, Matt. Given the choice, I'd prefer not to spend my evening plummeting to my death off a snowy clifftop.
Well, I don't know. I mean, we honestly don't know if that said danger. It could easily have said just Dano. Maybe it was like a sign for some dude named Dano fucking Clifton who just happened to live in the area. God damn, that joke fucking sucked. Can I just jump? No, the game's not going to give me the option of jumping. Okay, and wow, my fear of heights just sort of kicked in there. That wasn't cool. Dude, it's mountain elks. A whole lot of mountain elks. Hey, wasn't this the same cliff that the sisters died in during the prequel? During the prologue, rather. I ask out of sheer curiosity. Oh, and yeah, I kind of forgot that she was in the tub. Is she really listening to classical music? My god, there's actually a character with some level of taste.
Hello? Guys?
Where the hell did Sam get those scrapes? I don't... Oh, wait, yeah, the bird, never mind. She was like... attacked by a bird or some such stupid shit.
Okay.
So, wow, she's... Well, I could have sworn that she spent more time in the fucking tub. Ah, well.
Clothes, really? Whichever one of you did this is off my Christmas list. Seriously, not
the hell?
Cool, guys. Not cool at all.
So, alright, looks like they just left her down to a sock.
Chris?
Are we really going to do this shit again? Oh, god damn it. It'd be great if this game didn't do the I'm going to randomly wander and just start spouting out names thing. But okay, so the arrow says to go this way. And what a jaunty, happy little arrow that is. Huh. Really? Did the game really just try to turn a... Oh, God, they tried to get a jump scare out of a fucking grandfather clock. That is fucking sad.
Chris?
No, shut up, Sam.
Mike, Emily?
Shut up.
This is really getting out of hand, okay? It was all very funny, haha. Look at Sam walking around in a towel, but now I just really want this to be over, all right?
Yeah, I'm kind of getting that same feeling. We're only about halfway through the game, too. Ready for senior prom. Hannah, Sam, Mike, and Emily.
Am I supposed to hang out in a towel for the rest of the weekend?
April 25th,
2013. Towel is in. Trying to freak me out. Guess what? You succeeded.
How the hell are you freaked out? It's quiet. There's nothing happening. There's just balloons with arrows painted on them, and you're stupid enough to follow them.
The hell are you guys?
Well, let's see. I guess I should try to catch you up, Sam. At least two of them are dead. Unfortunately, I was a bit quick on the QTE,
guys,
otherwise we may have had a third
done
on there.
With this, I really don't appreciate the silent treatment here.
Hello, Samantha.
Oh god, Jigsaw's back.
Looking for me? I don't think you'll have much luck by looking, Samantha. You're only going to see what I want you to see. And I have quite a lot to show you.
What is going on?
Open your eyes.
Oh my god.
She's quite beautiful, isn't she?
What are you doing out there?
A beautiful bathing bird. Do you think she has any idea what lies ahead? Do you think these were the last happy moments of this creature's life?
Showing this to me.
Why are you watching?
Josh!
How does it make you feel? I'm going to give you 10 seconds. 9.
No,
8.
No.
7.
7.
Please,
6.
No.
Sam. Sam.
Throw the vase.
Shit.
Why? Why don't you people... Okay, there. You finally learned how to close a fucking door. Jump. That hiding place is way too obvious. Alright, now we have time to hide. You might want to turn the flashlight off, Sam!
Sam, why are you hiding? Sam, why prolong the inevitable?
Run! That's probably gonna cost
no!
Shit.
No!
There we go.
Are you kidding me? No handle?
Force it. Come on there. Come on there, muscles.
The hell?
No. There you go. Harder. Do it again. That's not going to keep him for too long, Sam. And again! Your life is in grave danger, but you're just gonna just saunter through like it's fucking nothing. God, I hate you people. You know, Sam, you could try, I don't know, jogging a little. Because I don't think that the big, beefy psycho is going to be... All right, let's hide again.
Oh, fuck. Fuck.
Yeah, get down in the crawl space.
I see you beaming at me.
Why didn't you shut the flashlight off, you stupid... bitch! Jesus!
Now, that was exciting, wasn't it?
Well done! The game seems to be going very well.
Well, Dr. Hill, it's nice to see that your office is back to normal.
Yes. All the good work I did exploring the source of your fear. And you've just gone and used it for ill. Overwhelming fear of isolation. You have turned it against these people who you so desperately want to torment. Has it been worth it?
Well, that was an interesting little chapter, you know, break. Yes, I totally have to see this again before I shut down the stream tonight.
Oh my god, we gotta get out of here.
Oh man, I was hoping that we would see more of Josh's death.
We need to go get some help. Hello? Guys?
Hello, Samantha. Looking for me?
We should look for the others.
Mike and Jess are off 69ing each other, and who knows where Sam is.
I think she's in the lodge.
Why are we still talking about this? Let's go!
Hey, look! Fire tower.
Matt, what is that?
I don't know.
Well, that was an interesting little previously on thing. Now, as much as I would love to see what else goes on, I believe that is where we are going to stop, at least for today. This has certainly been a lot of fun. We've only got about 4 chapters left, guys. About 2 more of these streams and the game will be done. And then we can go back to Quiplash, or Fibbage, or maybe I'll find another game like this and I'll keep doing live streams until I beat it all. Man, that was an interesting 2, you know, chapters. So, you know. So anyway, guys, that is going to do it for this installment of Let's Play Until Dawn Live. I have certainly had a hell of a lot of fun with this. The story's actually starting to pick up. The story's actually starting to get interesting, which is certainly cool. So I will see you guys next week when we do 2 more chapters of this. Unless I can get a couple days off from work, then who knows, maybe I'll do one of these even sooner. And then we'll be done with this game even faster. Don't know, we'll have to figure that out as the week goes on. So I will see you guys later. Really wondering if there's anything else I can really mention. If you guys head over to my Facebook page, if you head over to the official Facebook page, you will see a post where I have opened up a Discord server. You are totally free to go over there and chat and do all that fun stuff. Actually, I'm probably gonna just take the link off of that post and I will put it in the description of this video after I'm done going live, so you guys can click on that. You can join me over on the Discord server whenever I'm there. We can all chit chat and have fun. It's always a grand old time. Anyway, I am padding out this thing. I really shouldn't be padding it out this much. So I will see you guys next time. Take care. Peace.